viewers, my name is Peace Tunemili from Echo TV. I'm here on a peace summit by Cyprian, holding here in Akpakpava Youth House. And we are here to know what peace is all about, and we are here to know what is expected of this summit coming up here today. What peace summit is all about. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
My name is Peace Tunemili from Echo TV.
Okay.
May I know you, sir?
My name is Ahmed Buhari.
Okay. Tell us what peace summit is really all about.
Well, I think it's about time we gather ourselves together and start realizing that our differences isn't really our problem, you know. It's about time we start thinking about finding strength in our diversity, at the same time finding a way to have everybody included in the governance of the country, not just in inclusivity, but also equality to an extent, so that everybody has a fair share of the country, whether it be our prosperity, whether it be our resources, whether it be our identity as Nigerians. For so long, a lot of people feel marginalized, whether it be their economic instability or disenfranchisement from the system, or sometimes they actually feel they don't really consider themselves as Nigerians because they don't get involved in the governance or the polity of the country. So it's important that we start talking to people, sensitize the minds, let them know that the fact that you're different from me with regards to religion or tribe or any of those things is not what should divide us. What we should be fighting for is how we can come together, collaborate, and have a prosperous country.
Wow.
Economic viability is what's on top of our agenda.
Wow. That is lovely, sir.
Thank you
very much for
Thank
that.
Thank you.
Nice meeting you.
Thanks.
Yeah. Honorable Commissioner, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, my name is Peace Tunemili from Echo TV, Environmental and UTV show. And sir, please, I would just like, for the sake of the viewers, I would just like them to know you, sir.
Mika Amanoka is my name.
Okay, sir.
Privileged to be the Commissioner for Youth and Special Duties, Edo State.
Thank you very much, sir. And sir, please, I would like to know how you feel about what the youth just did. How do you feel about the peace summit that they just did right now, coming to this place, the peace work they did?
Yeah, it's a very nice outing, a very strong one. It's a strong signal, you know, to our leaders, to the international community, as well as the youth. Oftentimes, and many times, when crises break out, when there is war, it is the youth that suffer most. They are the ones that get killed most. They are the ones that are much more exposed. So when they say that the youths are usually the victims, it's understandable. Now, what the youth is saying is, we no longer want to be the victims. We want to be the promoters of peace. And it's quite commendable. And is the direction we should all go. Hate speeches are being made here and there. Who are those people that are really being used to drive those hate speeches? Are the youths. So the more we come out like this, the more we carry out sensitization, orientation, and promote this message of avoid hate speech, the more we try to foster unity, the more we try to foster a strong bond, the more we want to engender development, because no development takes place without peace. So it's a fantastic outing. We encourage it and we'll continue to support in the best way we can.
So we're very grateful. Thank you for using the word you continue to support the youth. So we appreciate you very much, sir, and we'd like to hear more from you concerning the issue of peace in our nation. Nice meeting you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. My name is Peace Tunemili from Environmental and UTV show.
Yeah.
So, sir, I would like to ask you one or two questions, sir. Sir, first of all, I would like the viewers out there to know you, sir.
Yeah, I'm Honorable Barrister Paul Ohombamu,
okay,
the Commissioner for Communications and Orientation.
Okay, sir. And sir, as you can see today, we heard a peace summit today by the youth. So, sir, I would like you to tell us how you feel about what they did, how you feel about the peace they are trying to preach to us Nigerians.
Thank you very much. I think it is a worthwhile venture, because you cannot have real peace,
yes,
without the essence not anchored on the efforts of the youth.
Yes,
this is precisely what is happening. But I just enjoin Nigerian youth to continue to be steadfast with, you know, concrete ideology, philosophy, principle that will bring them together, so that there are no infiltrations. You know, in his special message to the youths of Africa, after the second attack on the Bukanda prisons, which eventually became the last, And of course, the final onslaught on the Batista regime in 1959. Fidel Castro said, and I quote, "When people carry the same idea in their heads, nothing can isolate them. Neither prison walls nor the sword of cemetery. For the same philosophy, the same conviction, and the same principle has separated them all." At the end of the day, since we now know youths are the trustees of the nation's prosperity, then you know how to redirect the whole essence. I think Nigerian youths, you are vibrant. Nigerian youths, you are well, you know, red. You are solid. And nobody can intimidate you to submission. So I want to enjoin you that in that spirit, you must drive home your purpose. Anybody that lacks that internal logos for self-evaluation is not a human being. You must know that. Every normal human being must have an internal logos for self-evaluation. So as youth, I enjoin you to be nation builders. Not too young to run. It's one bill we are proposing at the national agenda. Youth, you can contest election no matter your age, because you are all boys and girls of full age and competent understanding. You contest election, you win election, and you do even better than some of our elders are doing. Thank you.
My name is Dr. Ayolola Ayoyimika. I'm from Nation Builders Organization. This peace summit is a summit put together for us to look at our nation and the future of our nation, and to look at it in line of peace, so that we are able to guide ourselves with the right thought, the right thinkings, with the right people, to be able to make sure peace reigns in the nation. You know, a nation without peace is going down the drain. And so that's why we have several organizations over here, so that we can talk on how we can sustain peace in our country, Nigeria. Thank you.
Yes, I started one last question. Is there a way for me, or this peace talk?
Oh, yes. So peace actually relates to everything. It relates to economy, it relates to environment, it relates to our families. So, but when it comes to environment, how does peace affect our environment? If our nation is peaceful, our farmers will be able to go to farm free. If our nation is peaceful, we will stop having high walls and barricades and plant our trees in front of our houses. If our nation is peaceful, we want to live a more green environment, because being at peace is being in good health. And we can't afford to keep messing up our environment and want to live in peace. So peace starts with you, starts from you. And when you talk about you talk about your health. So when you look at our environment, we're going to be able to consider ourselves too. So our peace affects us. Environment affects us. So when we talk about peace, environment is key. Thank you.
Thank you. I think you said it also.
Thank you.